Namaste, everybody. This is Sylvia Mordini, the founder of Alchemy of Yoga. This is your Yoga Sutras Jam, Chapter 1, Verse 11. This completes our series today. So hopefully you've been following along, but don't forget that you can rewatch all of the series on our IGTV or on my YouTube channel. So check them out. Well, let's dive in. This is so exciting. Here we go. The three translations that I'd like to share with you today about Chapter 1, Verse 11. Number one, memory is the retained impression of experienced objects. The second translation, memory is when a previous experience returns to conscious awareness. The third translation, when a mental modification of an object previously experienced and not forgotten comes back to consciousness, that is memory. So what are we talking about today? Memory. Of the five aspects of the mind, what is the mind? This is number five. We've gone through all other four, and now we're on number five. And number five has to do with memory. So I'd love to share a little bit more from Swami Satchidananda when we're considering what does memory mean and its impact on our happiness and our sense of peace. He says memories create impressions in the mind and at a later date come to the surface when we want them to, and sometimes even when we don't want them to. Hasn't that been the case in the scenario, right? And this is, I'll use a very popular word, where we can sometimes get triggered. So memories can appear and pop up when we're wanting to stoke that memory, but also equally when we're just going about our normal routine and all of a sudden something reminds us of something that has occurred and we get triggered in a really dark, negative, hurtful way. So both options can occur when we're looking at this concept of memory. He goes on to say that memories come in two ways, dreams when we're asleep and daydreaming when we're awake. So the impression from which, when formed, slowly descends like to the bottom of a lake in the mind. And it comes to the surface when it is rekindled for some reason. So I want to give you more about this idea or metaphor of the lake. So it's a still, quiet lake. That's like life happening in the moment. And then all of a sudden, bloop, 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 bubbles up to the surface, like little Pellegrino bubbles. All of a sudden are these memories from this experience that you're having, everything going along. Those are either going to reveal themselves when we're asleep or when we're going about in a daydream state, when we're in a wakeful state. But everything that occurs to us, this huge knowledge and this whole encyclopedia of experience, is like at the bottom of the lake. And then all of a sudden, like it just starts to tap in. If you want to watch a show that's really reveals so much about like memory, then watch Westworld, right? It goes deep into that expression. So these five ways that the mind expresses itself, that ultimately Yoga Chitta Vritti Niroda, right, the most important sutra, we are trying to regulate, manage, calm the fluctuations of the mind, knowing that they go in five different directions as well, in order to maintain peace and equilibrium, so that we're not constantly in a state of being emotionally agitated and then physically feeling like the impact of that emotion on ourselves. I also want to share this from Nishala Joydevi. We are constantly gathering data points from the impressions, experiences that form within us. Our concept stories and ideas need to be weeded out and released on a regular basis so our consciousness can keep evolving. Without this, we will continue to keep living in the past and we will get stuck, especially in pain. So it's not enough to know that, of course, you're going to have memories. There's an action required. Here, we don't just allow all of our memories to be maintained in this library of consciousness within us. We selectively see the ones that cause us harm and we selectively forget. That's a term from positive psychology. The happiest people do not remember everything. They have what's called selective forgetting, right? But you can do this on purpose through what? Meditation. Because you're not meant to remember everything, every grievance, every pain, every suffering. You're not meant to ignore them because it's really important never to repress the memory, to move through it, to acknowledge it, to meet it. Otherwise, it too will manifest as pain and cause disruption to your conscious life. So we can look at the weeding of the garden of our mind and say, does this serve me? As you're sitting in meditation and stillness and something bubbles up, you see it, you acknowledge it, and then you decide, is this a memory you're going to keep, or can you release it and let it go? Because do you have to hold on to that heartbreak and the pain from it and that grievance and that person that cut you off in traffic 10 years ago and what somebody said to you when you were in second grade and somebody else who hurt your feelings when you were in college? I mean, at some point, all that stuff is just taking up unnecessary room in your mind, and it's more ample opportunity to be triggered. So you meditate, you allow thoughts to come just one at a time, see them, decide, do I weed it or does it stay? Is it good? Creating a fertile garden in my mind for what I want to manifest or not. Let it go. Let it go. Release it. Give it up. Yes, it's occurred. You see it. And now thank it for its service and let it go on its way. So that's really the work that we're here to do, so that you can maintain this beautiful constant state of peace and equanimity. That yes, there's highs and lows and there's things that disturb us at times, but we have a through line, a sutra, as you will, that is always in a state of contentment, of joy, because the Yoga Sutras tell us that is our natural state. That's how we're born and that's how we're meant to live. So it's been a joy and a pleasure to be here with you guys 11 days in a row for Yoga Sutras Jam. You can see them all on our IGTV or on my YouTube channel. But thank you so much. And now for your homework, really take a look and make extra time to meditate this coming weekend and just allow things. If they want to bubble up, let them bubble, see them, acknowledge them, and then decide, keep it or release it. Catch and release, but with your thoughts. From my heart to your heart to the heart of the universe, namaste. Peace out, everybody.